meet the forces of darkness, the Ring Raiders prepare to take off. Battle stations are under attack.
Blaster on! Fire!
Missiles launched. Mission accomplished.
Planes and blasters sold separately.
Skull Squadron base fully armed and ready for action.
Skull base and planes sold separately.
Now you can enter the world of DC Comics superheroes.
My super strength will stop your power punch, Lex Luthor. But I can't stop Mr. Freeze and the Kryptonite Breeze. But Robin shut things down to stop.
Not even Penguin can defeat the powers of the superheroes. Action figures each sold separately from Sharon Toy. And now you can bring all the action of Batman home with a Batmobile, action figures, and more. Each item sold separately from Sharon Toy.
The A-Team, this afternoon at 4.
From your grandmother, all the way from Japan. You can open it, Yoko. It is addressed to you.
Okay. Will you please read the letter, Mama?
Of course. It says, "Dearest Yoko, I hope this letter finds you happy and well. When I was tidying my house today, I found something very special, and I thought of you. Your grandfather made this for your mother when she was as small as you are now. I am sending this special gift to you, Yoko. I hope that you will have as much fun with it as your Okasan did. Love, Obasan." Ah, oh, it is my old taketombo.
It's pretty. What's a taketombo?
I will show you.
It's wonderful. May I try?
Of course.
Like this? May I take it to school tomorrow for In the Spotlight?
You certainly may. It is very special.
Two to one! Get ready to run! Got it! I never miss!
I did it!
Good shot, Charles. Hey, where did my orange marble go? It's my favorite one.
I think this is yours, Timothy.
Thanks, Yoko. This one's special. My dad gave it to me.
I brought something special today, too. My grandmother sent it to me all the way from Japan.
Wow. What does it do?
Recess is over, boys and girls.
Oh, you'll see when I do my In the Spotlight.
Okay, everyone put away your things, then sit down under the learning tree. It's Yoko's turn for In the Spotlight.
Heads up, Fred. One, two, me to you!
Oh, that was close.
Frank and Frank, put your football in the cloakroom, please. You know we don't play football inside.
Yes, Mrs. Jenkins.
I'll put it away. Throw me a running pass.
Okay, but you better not miss.
I never miss. Oops.
Oh.
I missed.
Frank and Frank, you've broken Yoko's taketombo. What do you say to Yoko?
Sorry, Yoko.
Yeah, we're sorry. We didn't mean to break it.
I'm sorry, Yoko. Perhaps your mother can help you fix this. Let me help you pick up the broken pieces. We won't have In the Spotlight today.
Ah, you wrecked everything, Frank and Frank.
Her grandmother sent that to her all the way from Japan.
Poor Yoko.
Aw, no more In the Spotlight.
Quick sticks, everyone find a shape to sit on and we'll have a story now. Yoko, would you like to help me pick out a book?
Guess what's for dinner, boys?
I don't know.
Oh, come on. Not even a guess? Well, you're in luck. It's stewed brontosaurus with Brussels sprouts on the side. Mm-mm-mm.
Oh, good.
That is great, Dad.
All right, so it's Franks and Beans. Isn't that your favorite?
Great. Franks and Beans.
That is good.
So, how was school today?
Fine.
Anything special happen?
No. Well, we were supposed to have In the Spotlight, but...
We had a story instead. It was about the fire truck, and then there was a fire, and we all got to go, like that.
Well, that's great, Frank, but why didn't you have In the Spotlight?
Yoko was going to show us her toy, but it got broken.
It got broken?
It was an accident!
Is there something you boys want to tell me?
We broke it.
We were playing football when we weren't supposed to.
And we made Yoko feel really bad.
I see. Well, do you feel sorry?
Very sorry.
Really, really sorry.
And did you say sorry to Yoko?
Uh-huh.
Yes, we did.
Well, then I guess there's only one thing left to do.
What, Dad?
Finish the three sorries.
Three sorries?
I have never heard of the three sorries.
Well, first there's feeling sorry. Second, there's saying sorry. And third, there's doing something to show you're sorry.
Oh.
Then what?
Well, then Yoko feels better and you'll feel better too.
I want to do all three stories.
Me too. But how do we show Yoko we are sorry?
Let's get in the truck, boys.
All right!
Oh! Hello.
Good evening, Big Frank. And Frank. And Frank. Please come in.
Thank you.
This is good lemonade.
Yes, this is very good lemonade. Thank you.
We came over because of what happened in school today.
Oh, yes. the Taketombo. It is such a shame.
The boys have something they want to ask you, Yoko.
We want to fix your
Taketombo. Can we?
I'll supervise all the repairs myself. I've fixed so many things since the boys learned to walk that, well, I've become something of an expert.
Dad is a great fixer.
He will help us fix it.
Well, Cherry Blossom, what do you think?
All right.
Perhaps we should put the pieces in this, so none will get lost.
Do you think the glue is dry?
It should be dry by now.
Is it all right to take off the clamps?
Yes, I think so.
Be careful, Frank.
Very good, boys.
Yeah! We did it!
Now, you've done a terrific job, boys. I can't even tell it was broken.
Thanks, Dad.
Thanks for helping, Dad.
You know, I think there might be something else we can do for Yoko.
Something else? Okay.
I would like to do something else.
All right, then. Let's get to work.
Gather around the learning tree, children. It's time for In the Spotlight. Boys and girls, Yoko is going to show and tell us about a very special toy. Yoko?
This is a toy that my grandmother sent me from Japan. It was made by my grandfather for my mother when she was small, and now it belongs to me. It's called a Taketombo.
A taka what?
A Taketombo. In Japanese, it means bamboo dragonfly.
A bamboo dragonfly? Why is it called that?
I'll show you.
Interesting.
I wish I had one.
You will have one.
Really?
We will?
Frank and Frank, would you like to show everyone what you brought for In the Spotlight?
Okay.
Okay.
We're going to make Taketombos.
Like Yoko's.
Just you guys?
No, everybody.
All of us.
This is gonna be the best!
Frank and Frank know all about Taketombos. They did a good job of fixing mine.
That helped.
Yeah, that helped us.
Mine looks like a candy cane.
Make sure you paint both sides, Grace.
Painting mine to look like a real dragonfly.
Timothy, make sure you hold it tight while the glue dries.
Okay.
What do you think, Yoko? Should I add some sparkles?
Oh, yes. That would be pretty.
They're all pretty.
How about right now?
Yay!
Are you ready, Yoko?
Ready, Mrs. Jenkins.
Is everybody ready?
Ready!
One,
two,
three!
Nelvana Bookworm Bunch
will continue in a moment.
Bugs Bunny and other Looney Tunes collectibles have blown into town at McDonald's. But be careful of Daffy Duck, the Coyote, and Roadrunner, because people will stop at nothing to get their hands on them. And who could forget Sylvester and Tweety. For 59 cents each, you can collect all four of these varmints before they disappear.
Unleash the Typhoon, the only 9.6D radio-controlled hovercraft in the world. The Typhoon hovercraft blasts over the ground on a cushion of air. You command the Typhoon by radio control. Three powerful turbo motors for straight-line speed. Do a 360. Now, Typhoon hits the water. Incredible! The RC that runs on land and water. Typhoon, you've got the turbo power to handle anything. Typhoon, the only 9.6D radio-controlled hovercraft in the world. And only Tyco makes it.
Batteries not included.
Every girl has a secret treasure to keep.
Keepers, keepers, what's inside those keepers?
You can keep yours in a keeper like Diamond the Pony with his own secret hiding place, or Joyful the Rabbit with a hiding place too. And they all have long hair for you to brush.
Keepers, keepers, keeps it safe inside.
Diamond, Joyful, Princess, Fancy, Michelle, or Tango, each sold separately from Tonka.
Are you a member of the KVOS Junior Canucks Fan Club yet?
If you haven't already signed up, do it today. Here's how.
Just look for our booth at the Coliseum. You can sign up right there. Or you can send us your name, address, phone number, birth date, and $5 membership fee. $3 if you were a member last year. Safeway, Coca-Cola Classic, and Campbell's have joined our team this year. Why don't you?
So send them your name, because we want you on our team. I'll see you at the next home game.
Back to Timothy Goes to School.
Lily?
Yes, Mrs. Jenkins?
Did you remember to bring your permission slip back today?
Oh, yes, I did. I put it in my pocket so I'd remember to give it to you.
Thank you, Lily.
You're welcome.
Boys and girls, we now have permission slips from everyone. Yay! We're going to have a wonderful time exploring Hilltop Park.
I'm going to bring a blanket to sit on and an extra snack.
That's a very good idea, Grace.
I'm going to bring my bug jar.
I'm going to collect wild flowers.
I have to find a ribbon.
What for?
To tie around my finger so I remember to bring a blanket to sit on and an extra snack, just like Grace.
Good idea, Lily.
Do you have a ribbon, Fritz?
No, but I can help you look for one. I'm gonna bring my binoculars to Hilltop Park. Sorry, Lily. I don't see any ribbon.
Okay.
I'm bringing this fishing net to catch tadpoles.
That sounds like fun. I wish I had a net.
Here, Doris. Now you and Nora can fish together.
Great.
Thanks, Lily.
You're welcome. Do you have any extra ribbon, Charles?
Sure.
Thanks.
I'm going to bring my new kite to Hilltop Park, Lily. What are you going to bring?
A blanket to sit on and an extra snack.
You need to bring more than that for a field trip. You need bug spray and sunscreen and a flashlight, just in case.
I don't have enough fingers to remember all that.
Don't worry, Lily. I'll bring enough for everyone.
You always know what to do, Grace.
You can sit next to me on the bus if you like.
Thanks, Grace. Charles is bringing his kite, and Timothy's bringing his bug jar. And best of all, I get to be Grace's special friend and sit next to her on the bus.
You have a busy day tomorrow. Let's remember everything you need.
Don't worry, Mama. We won't forget.
We won't.
Mama.
Yes, Lily?
Did I tell you I'm going to be Grace's special friend?
Yes, dear. Night-night.
Grace knows all about going to the park.
Bug spray, check. Flashlight, check. Raincoat, blanket, and an extra snack. Check, check, and double check.
You've certainly thought of everything, Grace.
Thanks, Mom.
Bedtime. You have a busy day tomorrow.
I know. Good night, Mom.
Good night, Grace.
Lily, the bus is here.
Look, Mama. I remembered the blanket to sit on and the extra snack.
Well, we won't be needing this anymore. Good remembering, Lily.
Thanks, Mama.
Come on, Lily. Just one more stop and it's off to Hilltop Park.
I think everyone is very lucky to have you along on the field trip, dear.
Me too.
Hello, Grace.
Hi, Henry. See you later, Mom.
Bye, Grace.
Next stop, Hilltop Park.
Blankets here, Grace.
It's too sunny. We'll get hot. I think the best campsite would be under that shady tree.
Wow! This is the best spot, Grace. You can see the whole park. Let's go play. Charles said we can fly his kite if we want to.
I want to set up camp first. You go.
Hi, Charles.
Hi, Lily.
Look at me, Grace. Come and try.
I want to unpack my backpack first.
Okay.
Okay, boys and girls, everyone buddy up for a nature walk.
Grace, you can be my buddy.
All right.
Who can tell me the name of these flowers?
They're called tulips.
Well done, Grace.
What's this flower called?
That's a dandelion, and it's a weed.
Right again, Grace. But some weeds, like dandelions, are flowers too. Mmm, smell the flowers. Their sweet scent and bright color attracts the bees.
Hey, they smell like Mama's perfume. Come and try, Grace.
I already have tulips checked off in my field guide, so I don't need to smell them.
Look, there's a bug on me.
Don't worry, Lily. I've got some cream for bug bites.
It's okay, Grace. It's just a ladybug. And there it goes! Weren't the flowers beautiful, Grace?
Yes, and I checked off 4 new flowers in my field guide.
Sorry, Grace. I keep getting crumbs on your blanket.
Oh, crumbs are allowed on a picnic.
Ew! But not ants! I know! Let's follow them back to their anthill!
I want to move my stuff away from them first!
Okay!
Lily, have you lost something?
No, Mrs. Jenkins, I found something! Ants! Do you think the ants would like some of my sandwich?
Try and see!
Tell Grace. Grace? Grace? Grace?
I'm over here, Lily.
Wow, that was
it's fast. Grace, the ants ate my sandwich!
Look how fast I moved our stuff. Ooh, I'm hot.
I know! Let's get ice cream!
Okay.
I love ice cream.
Me too. Why do you have two ice creams, Yoko?
I'm waiting for Timothy. Henry took him for a boat ride.
Hi, Timothy!
Hi, Lily!
Hilltop Park is fun!
Are you having fun, Grace?
A bee!
Shoo, bee!
Shoo!
If you stay still, the bee will just go away.
It worked, Grace!
Of course it worked.
Grace always knows what to do.
Thanks, Henry.
Who wants to go for a boat ride?
I do!
Now, you need to wear a safety vest, Lily.
Here you go, Lily.
Can Grace come too?
There's only room for one at a time now.
You go first. I want to finish my ice cream.
Okay. Look, Henry, ducks!
Whoa, look at that! Quack, quack, quack!
Quack, quack, quack! Thanks, Henry! Wait until I tell Grace. Grace! Grace! Come see the baby ducks!
Baby ducks are called ducklings, Lily.
Are you moving camp again?
No, I'm packing up before it rains.
Quick sticks, children. Everyone back on the bus, please.
I'm all wet!
Me too.
Not me. I brought my raincoat just in case.
Good planning, Grace. You thought of everything.
Squeeze it, squeeze it, squeeze it.
How you drink a squeeze it depends on how you squeeze it. Squeeze it.
Squeeze it.
Squeeze it.
Squeeze it.
Squeeze it. Squeeze it.
Any way you want.
Now you can be a member of a fighter pilot squadron with flying fighters.
Listen to us fly!
Six incredibly detailed fighters with super electronic sound.
Knock on! Fire! Got them!
Flying fighters comes with patch and poster.
They're here. New Ultra Pretender. Inside each vehicle is another incredible pretender.
Beyond anything you've ever seen before. Transformer Ultra Pretender.
The ultimate Transformer experience.
Zero gravity cliffhangers. You race them through the giant loop, the death-defying spiral. Up the wall to zero gravity. And take the lead to win. Zero gravity cliffhangers with Night Glow from Tyco.
Jenga. You take a block from the bottom and you put it on top. You take a block from the middle and you put it on top. That's how you build a tower. You just don't stop till someone knocks it over, and that's when you stop. But you start all over putting blocks on top. Jenga from Irwin.
Our school is so cool. You can be a Sweet Valley girl. Going with a Sweet Valley girl. Our school
can get into Sweet Valley High, the game that is. Get the right clothes, throw the right party, date the right guy.
Jessica, you stole my boyfriend.
Just like in the book.
Get into Sweet Valley High, the game from Milton Bradley.
I'm Marvin, the tap dancing horse. Just shine that spotlight on me. Every show must have a star.
Dance, you can dance. You can dance, you can dance.
lights go down, I'm ready to perform. This is my home up on the stage. I'll dance for you,
and we'll perform for you too.
I'm Marvin the Tap Dancing Horse.
Gee, Jack, you sure have a lot of junk in this place.
Junk? Those are my memories you're talking about, Eddie.
Wow! You never told me you played football.
Nothing worth telling, really. It was a long time ago.
Can we go toss the ball around? Huh? Can we?
Sure, Eddie. Let's go. It's been a while, all right. Yeah!
Whoa! Woohoo! Yes!
This is great! Now, I can't chase you, Eddie. I've got a bum knee.
But I've got four good knees, so watch out, kiddo. Got room for a tap-dancing tackler in this game?
You can play football, Marvin?
Sure, didn't you ever see my movie, The Punting Pinto?
Wow! Can you ever kick?
Like a mule, Eddie. Like a mule.
Sensational!
Yeah! I got it! I got it!
Good hustle!
So, fast-talking Jack is putting together a football team?
We better go tell the boss.
Right. Shh. Tippy toes. Ow!
Football sure is a swell game, huh?
You bet. And it's even better when you're on a team and playing...
Unless you mess up and let the whole team down. Right, Jack? Why don't you tell them about the time you lost the championship?
That's ancient history, Lyman.
Let's have a history lesson then, okay? You see, Jack was the high school team's quarterback. On the last play of the championship game, Jack had the ball. Jack fumbled. Right to me. Which makes Jack a big loser.
Jack's no loser.
Yeah, he's forgotten more about football than you'll ever know.
Oh, well, I guess you boys would be up for a game against my clowns.
You're on.
We'll see who's the best coach, Jack or me.
Anytime.
Next Sunday. Come on. We got a ball game to get ready for.
No, not like that. Bounce.
Yeah, I got
that
that's one.
Yeah, that's two.
Come on. That's
hey,
it.
I got that four.
How about this ball game, boss? You bounce it, and then you try to... Hey!
Oh, no.
Hey, no. Oh.
I guess we told them.
Right. So what's our first move, coach? Jack?
Jack, we've been looking all over for you.
I've been thinking, maybe you should get somebody else to coach you.
Is this just because you lost that game all those years ago?
It wasn't that we lost. I let my teammates down. And I don't want to let you down, too.
You'll only let us down if you don't give it the old carnival try.
You're right, Marvin. Let's do it. Go see who else wants to play. I've got some planning to do.
Football? Count me in.
I'll go get my stuff.
Can I be a cheerleader? Chase him down a hall. Chase him up a wall. Come on, Jack's team. Let's play ball.
That's the spirit.
What's the matter, Elizabeth?
No one's asked me to play.
Think quick, Elizabeth. Nobody has better hands than a juggler. Ready to play some ball?
Oh, yes!
I'm all set, too.
Huh?
You can't play football in that getup.
Play? I'm
play-by-play. Their backs are against the wall. There's no tomorrow. Ooh, that's got her.
Okay, knees high through the tires. Should get you a new helmet.
No way! I want to wear yours.
Well, let's hope there's some luck left in it, Eddie, my boy.
It was Eddie.
Where is everybody?
Come on, get back here.
Come on, get back here.
Gee, boss, do you have any round footballs? This one bounces funny.
We stink. We can't learn this game fast enough to beat Jack's team.
Hogwash. You clowns already know everything you need to win.
We do?
Sure, you know how to cheat, fleece, lie, and bamboozle, don't you?
Yeah, right.
Well, when you play for Lime and Slime, that's all you need to know.
Ladies, gentlemen, children of all.
Heads!
Heads it is. You guys have to kick.
Hey, it's a two-headed coin. They cheated.
Look, Lyman will try anything to win, but we've got a secret weapon.
We do?
Yep. We're a team, and we look out for each other. Now go get them.
Yes!
And have fun!
Gotcha!
Hey!
Hello! We're over here!
We win!
And it's a clown touchdown! Hard to believe, isn't it?
Josh!
Jack's team will win the game! Go All-Stars!
seconds left.
We've got one last chance, Eddie. You're it.
Me?
Yep. We're gonna try a quarterback sneak. What's the matter, Eddie?
Well, it's all up to me now. If I fumble, I'll let the team down. And when you fumbled, you quit. I don't want to have to quit, too.
If we stop them here, we win. Now you clowns concentrate on the horse and the pig.
What about the kid?
Jack won't let him carry the ball.
Well, how come, boss?
Because that's how Jack lost the big game last time.
Oh! Look, Eddie, I didn't let my team down by fumbling. I let myself down by quitting.
We're in this together, Eddie. Win or lose, we're a team. What do you say?
Okay, Marvin, let's do it!
And here we go with the All-Stars' last play of the game.
Game's over for you!
You're not going anywhere, Marvin.
But you are!
Good work, boys. Hey, where's the ball?
Don't count your trophies till they're on your shelf. Look!
Eddie's at the 15, the 10, the 5.
Yeah!
Touchdown! Jack's team wins!
All right!
Yay, Eddie!
Way to go, Eddie.
Fantastic!
I couldn't have done it without you guys.
So, the old quarterback sneak, huh?
This team is full of surprises. Here, Lyman, you keep the game ball.
But we lost.
Exactly. The way you clowns play, you'll need the ball to practice for next year.
Hey, Jack, I thought you had a bad knee.
Well, it feels pretty good today. Maybe next year, I'll play too.
Hooray! Hooray!
Nelvana
Bookworm Bunch will continue.
Bugs Bunny and other Looney Tunes collectibles have blown into town at McDonald's. But be careful of Daffy Duck, the Coyote, and Roadrunner, because people will stop at nothing to get their hands on them. And who could forget Sylvester and Tweety? For 59 cents each, you can collect all four of these varmints before they disappear.
The big dream for every raisin is to be big enough for new Post-Raisin Bran cereal. But for these crispy flakes of bran, only one kind of raisin is plump enough, sweet enough, big enough. It's the California Raisin. Raisin Bran with California Raisins. New cereal, new box for all the right raisins.
3, 2, 1, lift off!
Whoa, Freddy!
Hang on, Eddie!
Whoa!
Now you can take off on your own adventure.
With a free activity book packed with puzzles.
And coloring pages.
And crafts and tons more fun.
And special Freddy's packs.
Let's go collect all three.
Dancing horse.
Oh! Oh! Oh my!
making that noise?
Did you hear it too, Marvin?
What is it?
It's coming from in there.
Hey! It's some kind of machine.
And it's eating Eddie!
Eddie!
Hey, let him go!
Oh, my goodness!
What's the matter? What are you hollering about?
We thought that, never mind.
Jack found it in the garbage dump and asked me to fix it.
Oh, but what is it?
It's a karaoke machine!
Wow!
Oh!
Karaoke? Oh, that's just great. Of all the loud, obnoxious, and annoying inventions in the whole world, the karaoke machine is the loudest, most obnoxious, and mostest annoying of all.
Mostest?
Can we give it a try?
Sure. Here's a list of the songs. Just pick one and punch it in here.
Jack should have left that thing where it belongs, in the dump.
I know the words to this one.
Way down upon the Swanee River, far, far away.
That's where my heart is turning ever. That's where the old folks stay. All up and down the whole creation, sadly I roam. Still longing for the old plantation and for the old folks at home.
What's all the caterwauling about? What's that thing?
It's a karaoke machine.
Why don't you give it a go, Edna?
Oh, I don't know. I come from a very unmusical family.
Go on, Edna. You might be good.
Oh, all right. Let's see here. Here's one I know.
Oh, sweet mystery of life, at last I found thee. The secret of it all. All thy longing, seeking, striving, waiting, yearning, the burning hopes, the joy and idle tears that fall.
Heavens to Betsy! Did I do that?
You betcha. You have a very powerful voice, Edna.
I'd better sweep that up.
You mean I sound okay?
Oh, yes, yes, very good.
Oh, yes.
Just lovely.
Nobody has a voice quite like yours, Edna.
You know, Jack always said if I came up with an act, he'd let me perform in the big show. Oh, boy, my very own act. I better go practice.
Her own act?
Her own singing act? Maybe she'll get better with practice.
Oh, lots of practice. Sounds like Edna's up.
Does she have to practice so early?
And so loudly?
And so badly?
Howdy, kids! You're up early!
practicing doesn't seem to be having any effect on her singing.
The poor dear, and she's trying so hard.
There goes the House of Mirrors.
I think we should have told her the truth about her singing.
Is she really going to sing in the show?
Don't worry, Eddie. Jack will put the kibosh on that idea.
Oh, that's right.
Good old Jack.
Say, Eddie, we got some broken glass out here.
I'll get the broom.
Jack, did Edna tell you about...
her act? She sure did. It's gonna be terrific.
Terrific?
Oh, yeah. It'll be a real showstopper.
Yeah, a showstopper, a show ender, and a carnival closer.
More broken glass?
Edna's blown out every light bulb in the carnival. And Jack says she's ready to sing. Tonight.
Tonight? Oh, no. Poor Edna.
Oh, Marvin, what should we do?
Something we should have done a long time ago.
Tell her the truth about her singing?
Yep. We'll get the others and do it all together.
No way.
I'm not telling her.
Oh, I couldn't.
We have to. It's because of what we said that she's going ahead with this. She'll be humiliated.
Oh, but she really, really, really wants to sing.
It's true. Oh. I've never seen her so excited.
All right, all right. Eddie and I aren't afraid to do the right thing, are we, Eddie? We'll tell her. Edna!
Come in! Hello, boys! You're just in time to help me pick out my costume. What do you think? Orange or yellow?
Whoa! Where'd you get all this stuff?
Belonged to my mom. She used to work in a carnival, too. She was a snake handler.
Edna? We just came by to...
You can meet Mom tonight. I invited her to come to my big debut. She'll be so proud of me. Now, what was it you were saying?
We just came by to say, knock 'em dead tonight.
Yeah, knock 'em dead, Edna.
Thanks, boys.
Marvin, Eddie, we're so proud of you two.
You were absolutely right about telling Edna the truth. I'm so glad you told her.
Well, we didn't actually say...
How do I look, kids?
Wonderful.
Beautiful.
Stunning.
Thanks.
Oh.
Better go and wait for my cue. See ya.
You didn't tell her?
She invited her mom.
I wonder which one she is.
I can take a guess.
Bring on Edna! We want Edna!
We have to tell her before it's too late.
Edna, wait a minute. Wait.
What do you want? I've got to go on right away.
Edna, we're really sorry we didn't tell you before, and we don't want you to be embarrassed, but, well... you're not really quite good enough to do a singing act.
Well, no kidding. Duh. I'm a terrible singer.
You knew all along?
Of course I knew. Don't you know what my act is?
And now, ladies, gentlemen, and children of all ages, the one, the only... Edna, the glass-breaking sensation!
Glass-breaking?
Woo-woo! Yeah! Yay, Edna! Woo-woo! Yay, Edna! All right, woo-woo-woo!
secret of it all.
That's my girl. She's a natural.
I'll get the broom.
Oh, good for you,
Edna. You were a big hit, Edna.
Yeah, we'll have to add you to the poster.
No, this was just a one-shot deal. If I did that every night, I'd have no voice left to tell fortunes.
Say, where's Stripes?
I'm called Little Buttercup, dear Little Buttercup, though I could never tell why. But still I'm called Buttercup, poor Little Buttercup, sweet Little Buttercup.
Bravo!
Stripes, what a golden voice!
Coming up next on Seven Little Monsters.
I finally get to be the lead swan in the ballet recital, and my tooth is going to fall out.
Enough of your nonsense. It's time for mine. There, there, little lady. There's no point in crying over spilled tea.
Maybe we could make my tooth stay in my mouth just until the dance recital is over.
The dentist is on the case.
Bookworm Bunch will continue in a moment.
We want ice cream!
Almost ready!
We need ice cream in just 3 minutes!
Meepers!
Can it make vanilla?
Can I have sprinkle?
You make real ice cream in 3 minutes with a 3-minute ice cream maker. Ice and salt, milk and mix. And 3 minutes later, homemade ice cream.
Delicious!
I made it myself!
Cream maker with 22-piece set. New from Tyco.
Take to the streets with Tyco's 9.6-speed turbo hopper. Radio-controlled cars with powerful speed and rechargeable 9.6-speed power. Kick in the turbo and get the full 9.6-speed power jolt. New 9.6-speed turbo hopper. Each sold separately. Batteries not included.
When she's cold, she quivers. Batteries not included.
All my loving, yours to take.
Dennis the Menace, weekday afternoons at 3.
They go.
four, five, six, seven little monsters. Hey!
Listen, Hare, you're not the boss of me. I'm the boss of you.
Huh? Oh, brother.
Oh, you handsome devil.
I am the Swan Queen. Oh, sorry, Four. Hey, I like what you've done with your hair.
Gee, thanks, Six.
How can one improve on perfection? Oh! Oopsie. Oh, dear. I don't believe it. I have a loose tooth.
When you have to make your bed, do your feet and then your head. First the sheet and then the blanket. When you're done, be sure to thank it. If you learn this little rhyme, you'll make your bed right every time.
Be sure to look out for your nose, otherwise this way it goes.
Hold still, Five!
Tickly!
Perfect!
It's the end of the world!
Oh, dear.
Never mind that, Seven. Something terrible has happened, and my life as I have known it is about to be over.
Six, what's wrong?
Just everything.
What now? Mom washed your favorite tutu and it faded?
Much worse. Although that is pretty horrible for. My tooth! My perfectly wonderful perfect tooth is loose!
Does it hurt?
What does it smell like?
Let's have a look-see.
You've got to take your hands away, Six, or we won't be able to see it.
Ooh, spooky.
Cool, Six.
It isn't cool, Four. It isn't cool at all. It's terrible.
Since you put it that way.
Put Four down, too.
Okay. Four has bad breath and throws like a girl.
No, not that kind of put down, too. Put Four back down on the floor.
Oh, sorry, Four.
Oh! Well, thanks a bunch.
Why are you so upset, Six? It's only a loose tooth.
Finally get to be the lead swan in the ballet recital, and my tooth is going to fall out.
But swans don't have teeth.
That's not the point. If I don't have a tooth, I won't be beautiful. How can I be a swan when I look like an ugly duckling?
Look on the bright side, Six. When you lose the tooth, you can get a job at the circus. I'd bet we'd even get free hot dogs.
Hot dogs?
Cut it out, Four.
I just don't understand. My tooth was fine yesterday. Why has it come loose all of a sudden?
Oh, golly. What if Six has a strange tooth-loosening virus that will make everyone's teeth loosen and fall out? Then we could only drink juice and eat porridge.
Porridge?
Don't be ridiculous, Seven.
It could happen, Four. In fact, I think my nose is getting loose.
Oh, dear. I think my head is loosening.
Your head is always loose, Seven.
Good point.
Enough of your nonsense. It's time for mine.
And who are you supposed to be, Three?
That's Dr. Three, my little green friend, and don't you forget it. Doctor of Dentistry, Orthodontia, and Shoes.
Yeah, what a heel.
What we have here is a dental dilemma.
Hey, watch it.
You two remind me of an anteater I once caught in my pajamas. How he got in my pajamas, I'll never know.
You must have had ants in your pants.
I didn't know I was working with a partner. Two, if your mouth is as big as your nose, I could be able to retire early. How loose is this loose tooth? Is it a tricuspid, bicuspid, or a henway?
What's a henway?
About 4 pounds.
I had to ask.
Dr. Three, it's Six's tooth that is loose?
Why didn't you say so? Hello, Toots. Open up and let Dr. Three have a peek. Ah, I see what the problem is. You seem to have a bunch of fingers in your mouth. Come, come now. There's no reason to be shy. It's not like I'm going to hurt you. You, on the other hand.
Why, I ought to...
As I was saying, on the other hand, there's 5 fingers. Now then, open wide. Oh, you're shaking your head, which means no, no, no. Oh, you mean yes, yes, yes. So, what are you waiting for, sister? Open your mouth. And people say that I'm confusing. I've got just the thing for such an occasion.
Try as you might, doctor, you're not going to get me to open my mouth.
Works every time. Now, let's have a look-see. Very interesting.
What do you see?
You should definitely floss more. Fascinating. Well, Six, as a qualified dentist, I can definitely say without a doubt that you have a loose tooth.
I thought you said you're a doctor, not a dentist.
Well, a dentist is a doctor of teeth. But that still doesn't mean I know what I'm talking about.
What can you do to help me, Dr. Three?
Using just this wheelbarrow, some anchor chain, Belinda the cow, and a grandfather clock, I can rid you of that pesky tooth.
What's the clock for?
To tell what time it is. I'm billing it by the hour.
Oh, I don't want to lose my tooth.
It has to fall out sometime.
No, I won't let it. Why would any tooth want to fall out of my mouth? It has a very nice place to stay right where it is.
Oh! There, there, little lady. There's no point in crying over spilled teeth. It's the most natural thing in the world. The reason the tooth falls out is a new tooth that's even stronger and shinier is waiting to come in. And the old tooth has to move out of its way.
Really?
Absolutely. Two, hit the lights.
He meant turn off the lights.
Sorry.
Aww. That's fine.
When we are born, it looks like we don't have any teeth. At first, all we can see are our gums. The gums are the pink ceilings and floors of our mouths. But if we were to take a closer look, we'd see that there are tiny teeth inside those gums, just waiting to come out. We call them baby teeth. That goes without saying. It takes about a year for the first few baby teeth to come in, but it isn't very long before we start to get bigger. Our mouths get bigger, and as our mouths get bigger, then it's time for the big teeth to come in. Bigger mouths mean bigger foods, and to chew those bigger foods, we need those bigger teeth. But if those big teeth are gonna have enough room, the baby teeth are gonna have to come out. One by one, the big teeth fill in the spaces left by the baby teeth. These teeth will last you forever if you take good care of them. Brush and floss and see the dentist 2 times a year. Now then, didn't that sound like I knew what I was talking about?
You never know what you're talking about.
Precisely, but the important thing is your tooth wants to come out to make room for the big tooth.
I don't care what my tooth wants. I can't be a swan with a big hole in my teeth.
Oh. May I just point out again that swans have no teeth?
Guys, I think maybe we should leave Six alone for a while until she's feeling better.
Yeah, one's right. Six needs to chew on this by herself for a while.
Four.
Sorry. I guess I hit a nerve.
Out.
Three? Maybe we could make my tooth stay in my mouth just until the dance recital is over.
My dear Six, the dentist is on the case.
More careful being with the stretching.
Sorry, Mother.
Come over here, Six. Ta-da!
What is it? Is this going to keep my tooth from falling out?
Well, if it doesn't, then my name isn't Rufus T. Quackenbush.
But your name isn't Rufus T. Quackenbush.
Precisely. Just stand still, Six, and let me work my magic. genius. Or something that rhymes with genius.
But nothing rhymes with genius.
No, nothing rhymes with nothing. Except maybe, pluthing or crothing. Well, that proves my point. Now, Six, back to you. It's an inflatable dental shock-absorbing cocoon. It protects you from harmful vibrations that could jar your tooth loose.
I can't move at all. How am I supposed to dance in the recital?
Badly.
Uh-oh.
Well, I certainly get an A for effort. Say, if you thought my last idea didn't work, wait till you see this one. It's my soon-to-be patented anti-tooth-loosening helmet.
Heavy.
What did you say?
It's heavy.
It's heavy. Is that what you said? Good, because for a moment there, I thought you said it was heavy. Anyway, my dear, let's see you dance. Okay, make with the boogie-woogie. And I do mean boogie. A thing of beauty, Six. I see swans. Now leap, my little swan. Take flight. Okay, so it needs a little work. I suppose you could do better? It's a good thing I get those light bulbs wholesale. Belinda, whatever I'm paying you, it's not enough. And if I am paying you, it's entirely too much. Trust me, Six, because if you don't, who will? Certainly not me.
Are you sure?
Smile for the birdie.
I feel silly.
But is your tooth wiggling?
No.
Well, what do you know? I actually surprise myself sometimes. And the gum is sugar-free. Okay, Swan Cakes, be the dancer of my dreams. Or at least show me why I haven't been getting enough sleep. If I didn't know better, I'd swear you could dance. I can hear the applause already. You'll be the toast of the town. And if you do get the toast, I'll take mine with bacon and eggs. Whoa! I wonder if I have another appointment I should be at right now. I'm sure there's a bright side to this. And when I find it, I'll mail you a letter. If I had any sense at all, I would have given up by now. But where there's a will, there's a way. Whatever that means.
I know. I'll just not eat until the recital is over. If I don't use the tooth, it won't get any looser and it won't fall out.
Six, if I didn't know better, I'd say you went to the same school of dentistry I didn't attend.
Nelvana
Bookworm Bunch will continue in a moment.
Bugs Bunny and other Looney Tunes collectibles have blown into town at McDonald's. But be careful of Daffy Duck, the Coyote, and Roadrunner, because people will stop at nothing to get their hands on them. And who could forget Sylvester and Tweety? For 59 cents each, you can collect all four of these varmints before they disappear. Snap the pieces together. It's as easy as that. Now you've learned the knack to start bending and shaping new creations with your Zack. Zack, a new toy with every twist. Zack that each sold separately. From Irwin. Zack.
My name is Teddy Ruxpin. Can you and I be friends? I really...
Everybody out!
Teddy Ruxpin from Worlds of Wonder.
Batteries not included.
Now you can be a member of a fighter pilot squadron with flying fighters.
Listen to them fly!
Six incredibly detailed fighters with super electronic sound.
Hawkeye! Fire! Got him!
Flying fighters comes with patch and poster. They're here. New Ultra Pretender. Inside each vehicle is another incredible pretender.
Beyond anything you've ever seen before. Transformer Ultra Pretender.
The ultimate Transformer experience.
His name is Jack. He's new in town. Lunchtime is when he gets down. But he can't stop the cop a snack. Cause he's a Lego maniac. No one seems to have a knack of Lego motion like that Jack. They can't help it. They jump in. Crazy just like him, Jack. He's a Lego maniac, Jack.
Lego Town and Space Sets, each sold separately from Lego Systems. Batteries not included.
It's your old pals along with some new friends in Chippendale's Rescue Rangers.
This afternoon at 3:30 on KVOS TV 12.
Now return to Seven Little Monsters.
Eat, my kinderlings, for the energy you're needing. My sixling is eating very fast. Eating all of the porridge, but growling still is your stomach? When cow is fat and stomach is growling, thinking I am, there is something you are not telling me.
She doesn't want to eat because she has a loose tooth.
Let us see this loosening tooth. Six. Loose tooth or no, eating you must. Food is for making healthy. Here is being your favorite, a marshmallow.
Come on, Six. It's only a soft little marshmallow.
That tooth will probably use it for a pillow.
Nothing to be afraid of.
Smells like a good idea.
As your dentist, I advise you to eat it.
Oh, no. Look at me. How can I go to the recital now?
Sixling.
Don't be sad, Six.
No, I'm ugly. My beauty has been cruelly snatched away.
We still think you're beautiful, Six.
Yeah, even if you are ugly. What did I say?
Six, upsetting you should not be. The losing of the toots is to everyone happening.
Oh.
Better you should be feeling, yes? You were leaving this down the stairs.
I don't want it.
Oh, my darling. Taking it, you must be.
What for? It made me ugly.
For to be putting it under your pillow tonight.
Why would I want to do that?
How can this be? You are not knowing the story of the tooth dwarfs?
Tooth dwarfs?
Listening now, and you are hearing a story my mama told me, and her mama told her. Whenever a little monster is a tooth losing, they are putting it under the pillow at night. Then, while they are making with the sleeping, the tooth dwarfs, far away in their mountain made of lost teeth, begin working with the magic.
Okay, tooth dwarfs, we've got the green light, and green means go. Subject is asleep. Okay, prepare a tooth for departure.
In the heart of Tooth Mountain, the tooth dwarfs are growing the new teeth for all the children who are losing them.
Okay, this one's ripe.
Got it.
Check. Perfecto.
Okie dokie. Time for polish.
Wax on. Wax off.
Ooh, rubble.
Then, the tooth dwarves are boarding their magic flying tooth cart with pulling by their flying cow.
All aboard!
Has Belinda eaten her magic flying porridge?
Roger, Vilco!
Flying porridge.
Ready for takeoff.
Check.
Tooth secured.
Check.
Door open.
Check. And a waitress to go.
Belinda ready? And away we go. Have you been eating the magic flying porridge again?
Sorry.
There, that's the place. Nice landing.
I had to hold on to five so I couldn't steer properly. There. Now stay out of trouble.
Quiet. You'll wake her up.
Four, you and seven get the new tooth into position. The rest of you, follow me. Two, three, nose jack maneuver.
Roger, Wilco.
Hurry up, four.
Got it! Nothing but net.
When you lose a tooth, never have a fear, because the friendly tooth dwarfs are always very near. They will bring a new tooth from their magic place and leave you something nice to put a smile upon your face.
First, some magic painless dust.
So it won't hurt a bit.
Let's go. Our job here is done.
And with the lucky little monster's new tooth in place, the tooth dwarves are then flying back to their tooth mountain after a good night's work.
Is that true?
That legend has been being in my family for many years, my Bubba-Link. So now, with the putting of your tooth under your pillow tonight for the tooth dwarves.
Yes, Mother. Mwah.
Night, my kinderlings.
Good night, Mom.
You tooth dwarfs aren't going to take my tooth. And tomorrow I'll find a way to stick it back in for good. There. Just try and get my tooth now. And I'll lie with my head on this bag of rocks so I won't go to sleep. Oh, Six, you are so clever. You'll never fall asleep in a million... Oh, no. I fell asleep. My... They came! Oh, my. Nobody has to see my ugly teeth. This is one swan who'll never smile.
So exciting this is for me and my mushkas.
You bet, Mom. Seven, the boy behind you can't see the stage.
Sorry. Is that better?
Shh.
Poor Six. She looks so unhappy.
And this should be the happiest day of her life.
If only someone had an idea that would make her smile.
I wonder why I never get tired of that joke.
What joke?
Black licorice and 12 hard-boiled eggs. And hold the hard-boiled eggs.
I am knowing. Sometimes in the body there is changing. Like with tooths, making changes is for making big, happy smiles.
Coming up next on George Shrinks.
It was T minus 24 hours until Becky's 11th birthday.
George and Junior, meet Daisy.
I was gonna be dog sitting Daisy. I knew I was gonna have fun, but I didn't know what a wild ride it would be.
Whoa! Stop! Heel! Logo! Whoa!
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. My brothers and my sisters, I'm gonna help them shine. My brothers and my sisters, I'm gonna help them shine. My brothers and my sisters, I'm gonna help them shine. Help them shine.
Bookworm Bunch will continue in.
Oopsie Daisy is learning to crawl. She's such a pretty baby. She crawls to me as nice as can be. Oopsie Daisy. Oopsie Daisy loves to crawl, but when she falls, she needs someone like you to love her. Oopsie Daisy, batteries not included.
It's a barrel of laughs, a barrel of fun. But can you get the monkeys one after one? You gotta be kinda careful, cause monkeys really monkey around.
Barrel of monkeys, how many can you pick up? A barrel of fun from Irwin.
Now you can enter the world of DC Comics superheroes.
My super strength will stop your power punch, Lex Luthor. But I can't stop Mr. Freeze and the kryptonite breeze. Robin shut things down to size.
Not even Penguin can defeat the powers of the superheroes. Action figures each sold separately from Sharon Toy. And now you can bring all the action of Batman home with a Batmobile, action figures, and more. Each item sold separately from Sharon Toy.
Oh, wow, look at this. From the magical world of blue.
Wow, how'd you change your outfit?
This is Luna's treasure.
changes color, so I can dress her all kinds of different ways. She's got a magical ponytail that changes color, too.
She's amazing!
Little Miss Dress Up!
Oh, I see you've got my Kellogg's Corn Flakes again. You know Corn Flakes are daddy's cereal, son. And I'm afraid you'd have to come up with a pretty convincing argument to get me to change my mind.
Kids love Corn Flakes, it's what they like. They eat it in the morning and they eat it at night. It ain't just for mommies, it ain't just for dads. All kids like it and they like it real bad. Bad, bad, they like it real bad. So you can't keep a kid out of Kellogg's Corn Flakes.
Well, that was pretty convincing, son.
Well, the boy's kind of small.
George shrinks.
But it doesn't show at all.
George shrinks.
Because he's always acting tall.
George shrinks.
George shrinks, George shrinks, he's called. If a problem should be found,
George shrinks.
He's the boy to have around.
George shrinks.
Something big or something small.
George shrinks.
George shrinks, George shrinks, he's called. George always seems to find a way to make his dream come true each day. His brother Junior does a call.
George shrinks.
Well, Dada blows a bugle call.
George shrinks.
And Mama keeps an eye on all.
George shrinks.
George shrinks. George shrinks. George shrinks. George shrinks. George shrinks.
Saturday morning, 9 a.m. It was T-minus 24 hours until Becky's 11th birthday. And this year, we were throwing her the best kind of party of all. A surprise party. Since I'm Becky's official best friend, and since the secret shindig was going to be launched at our pad, I was up extra early to make sure everything was done on time and with the usual shrink style. Going in. First on my list was the invitations. After all, what kind of surprise party would it be without guests to yell surprise? Bullseye! Cooper House, dead ahead. Hilda and Henry Cooper hold the record for the most cake eaten at one birthday party by twins. And they always bring great presents.
Hope you can make it, and remember, mom's the word!
Party headquarters to Commander Shrinks. How's the mission going? Over.
Commander Shrinks here. The invites have been safely delivered.
Good job, sir. There's a mug of Frosty OJ with your name on it, waiting back at base.
We're bringing this bird home. Over and out.
Of course, the trickiest part of pulling off a surprise party is the surprise. And the closer the surprisee lives to the surprisers, the more tricky it becomes. See what I mean? Switch to super stealth mode. Engine on. Super glider on. Uh-oh. Not enough lift. Looks like Commander Shrink's cover is about to be blown. All clear. Yikes. Trouble at 12 o'clock. And super. This is no time to play George the Human Cat Tour. A surprise party host is a big responsibility, which is why I was just the guy for the job. With my perfect party plan, Becky's birthday was gonna be a snap. Okay, guys, time to get cracking. We've got a lot of stuff to do before the surprise party tomorrow.
Surprise party?
Uh-oh.
That's right, honey. We're having a birthday party for Becky, but it's a secret.
Yeah, Junior. A secret.
Shh. Okie dokie, George.
Before Becky comes over, we all hide.
As soon as she opens the door, we jump up and yell, "Surprise!" and make all the hullabaloo we can.
Surprise! Surprise! Surprise!
Hey, you got it, Junior. Hey, you're a natural.
Okay, so here's my super surprise party planning list. If we divvy up the duties, we'll be ready to party in no time. Invitations? Check. Cake?
Cake! We love cake.
We all love cake, Junior. But baking is a job for our resident cake artist, Mom.
All ingredients and baking tins present and accounted for. I'm going to make the most original, extra-fluffy, triple-decker shrinks family pink poof cake ever. If I can just come up with a design that says Becky's birthday.
Whatever it looks like, Mom, it'll be great. Okay, next. Rake the leaves and set up picnic tables for the party outside.
Junior, help George.
I don't know about you moving furniture, Junior.
Well, I think I'm your outdoor man, George.
Great! Decorations, streamers, balloons, and last but not least, a piñata filled with goodies.
Me do piñata, George?
Piñata and decorations are my department, Junior.
Junior, help?
Looks like everything's covered, buddy.
Okie dokie, George.
Now, you had to admire Junior's can-do attitude, but of course he was too little to really help Operation Surprise Party. I just had to find another Junior job. Something easy, but fun enough to keep him out from underfoot. Wait, Junior. There is one very important job I almost forgot. We need an official noisemaker tester.
Junior, help!
That's a spirit. Let's see. First I'll hang streamers and balloons.
Just whistling Dixie. That's some tootin', son. Keep at it, one day you'll be blowing with your old man's band.
Lift off. All party systems are go! Party Express was humming on all cylinders. Becky's pop was at home making his world-famous poblano sauce. Mom and Dad were hard at work. But there was only one small problem. Someone was doing his job a little too well.
Making down to a science. Why don't you go ask your big brother how else you can help?
Okay, Mommy. George?
Hey, Junior!
George?
In here, big guy! Trying to figure maximum candy volume. Whoa! Junior! Whoa! Put me down gently. Okay, Junior? George to ground control. Time for re-entry.
Junior, help Candy.
Junior,
I have a different job for you, but it's very important.
Me help.
I need someone to bring a bunch of pillows down for tonight's scary movie marathon. Think you can handle it?
Okie dokie, George.
Okay, so it was sort of a make-work project. But this way, Junior could make himself useful and scarce at the same time. With him out of the way, it looked like I had everything under control. I got it!
Who there, George?
Becky's mom. Must be coming to see how the party's coming along.
Hi, George. How's everything going?
Operation Surprise Party is running like clockwork. Everything's right on schedule.
I knew I could count on you, George. Here, I brought some candy for the piñata.
Mrs. Lopez, you're, wiggling. And whimpering.
George and Junior, meet Daisy.
Oh, it's a puppy!
Puppy! Puppy!
Hey!
Becky's been asking for a puppy forever, and now that she's turning 11, I think she's ready.
What a great surprise!
Oh, I hope I can keep her a surprise. I'm gonna try and hide her until the party, but she's awfully squirmy. And barky.
You can leave her here until tomorrow.
Oh, no, George. You've got your hands full already. A puppy's a lot of work, even for one day.
If I can deliver all the party invitations and decorate the whole house, I can handle watching a little puppy for one night. See? Kids and puppies are a perfect fit.
All right, George. If you're sure, and if your mom says it's okay, she's all yours.
All right. Come on, pup. Let's check with the top dog. Whee! How's it going, Mom?
It's going to be a work of edible art. As soon as I decide on a design.
Can I watch Becky's present till tomorrow?
Present? What present?
Mom, meet Daisy.
A puppy!
It's just for one day, and it's a puppy, and kids and puppies are a perfect fit.
That's perfect. I'll make an extra fluffy triple-decker shrinks family pink poop puppy cake.
So, it's okay?
Just until tomorrow? Do you think you can handle it?
Sure, it's a piece of cake.
Okay, George, if you can take care of her, she's all yours.
Yee-haw! Get along, little doggie. It's a go.
Here's her things. Thanks again, boys. See you tomorrow. Mum's the word.
So, for the next 24 hours, I was gonna be dog-sitting Daisy. I knew I was gonna have fun. But I didn't know what a wild ride it would be.
Nelvana
Bookworm Bunch
will continue in a moment.
Bugs Bunny and other Looney Tunes collectibles have blown into town at McDonald's. But be careful of Daffy Duck, the Coyote, and Roadrunner, because people will stop at nothing to get their hands on them. And who could forget Sylvester and Tweety? For 59 cents each, you can collect all four of these varmints before they disappear.
The Typhoon hovercraft blasts over the ground on a cushion of air. Now, Typhoon hits the water. Incredible! The RC that runs on land and water. Typhoon, the only 9.16 radio-controlled hovercraft in the world. And only Tyco makes it.
Batteries not included.
Now, Tyco brings you twin turbo trains. Two trains packed full of excitement, breaking the law of gravity as you streak upside down. Hit the switch, and you can race them side by side. Take control, feel the speed. Twin turbo trains new from Tyco.
When your best friend calls, your case is packed with, especially for girls, you're a traveling act. Each one's a game you can grab and run, and you're ready for a night of all girl fun. There's what you believe in, dear, diary to share, a part of your bag with room to spare. Especially for girls, you can play them all night, or at least till they make you turn off the light. Especially for girls, games to go in their own carry case, each sold separately, toothbrush not included, from Play Toys.
Fight the forces of darkness, the Ring Raiders prepare to take off.
stations. We're under attack.
Blast them on. Fire.
Missiles launched.
Mission accomplished.
Planes and blasters sold separately.
Skull Squadron base fully armed and ready for action.
Skull base and planes sold separately.
All I have to do is keep you occupied while I fill the piñata and wrap Becky's present.
Me play puppy?
Oh, no, Junior. We have to keep those pillows coming.
Okay, George.
Okay, girl. Let's see if you know any fancy tricks. Daisy, sit. Ugh. Don't know sit, huh? Well, sit is like this. Good girl, Daisy. Now stay. 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 Good girl. Guess you can teach a new dog old tricks, huh, Daisy? Hold on there, Junior.
Candy!
These are for the piñata. But I'll put a couple away, and if Mom says it's okay, we'll have them once the pillows are all down. Deal?
Okay, George. Pillow. Pillow.
Better get these in a safe place. What was that?
Oh, not so fast, you! Get back here!
Uh-oh. Runaway dog. Stop, Daisy! Stop! Sit! Phew. Nice roadblock, Junior. Nice of you to play fetch with Daisy.
I don't think little Miss Daisy is playing. Well, she has good taste anyway. She went straight for the icing, snout first.
Sorry, Mom.
That's okay. Try keeping a closer watch on her. I'd prefer my puppy cake without fur.
Me watch dog?
I don't think so, Junior. You're my go-to guy on the pillow patrol.
Okay, George. Bye-bye, doggy.
Let's see. If the kitchen's calling, you must be hungry. One doggy donut, extra meaty flavored, coming up. Aha! Thought so. That ought to keep you busy for a while. Better get Becky's other present wrapped while I have the chance. Becky's piñata is going into orbit! On its own! Daisy!
George, everything all right?
Sure. Everything's fine. Whoa, there! Easy. There you go.
Are you sure you can handle Daisy, George? You've got a lot on your plate.
Like I said, easy as pie.
Maybe Junior can help you out.
He's just a little kid. Don't worry, Mom. I told Becky's mom I can take care of it. From now on, Daisy's staying put.
Okay.
This calls for some sharp shrinks thinking. Time for a little game of fetch, George style. Here, Daisy! Come and get it! That ought to keep you out of trouble. Of course, luring a puppy into a cardboard box is one thing. Keeping her there is another. Hmm. Looks like I'm gonna need more candy. Atta girl. Be right back. Okay, ready for candy deployment. Here they come! Becky's gonna love it. Don't you think, Daisy? 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 Daisy, where are you, girl? Daisy! Daisy had gone from here to who knows where in under 5 minutes flat. And so had my party plans. Operation Surprise Party was officially off schedule. How could Daisy have gone away so fast? If I've lost her new puppy, Becky's parents, and Becky will never forgive me. Daisy? Daisy, where are you, girl? Daisy! I launched a full-scale aerial search. I checked all the usual escape puppy hiding spots. And a few spots that only a kid my size would know about. But it was starting to look like Becky's new dog was doggone gone. I searched the whole house. There was no other choice. I was gonna have to bring in the big guns, Mom and Dad. But as luck would have it, Daisy. Oh no, the cake! There she was, caught with her paws in the cookie jar. A pooch after my own heart. There was no way I was letting her chow down on Mom's masterpiece before the party. That's right, girl. Nothing like a good old-fashioned game of chase me. Steady, girl. Gotcha! Now all I've got to do is tie to something. Something big.
Party patrol reporting in. One last pile to bag.
Dad, quick, close it! Whoa! Stop! Heel! Oh, this is a pinata! Whoa! What's the... Hey, who turned off the lights? Daisy, stop! Whoa, go! Whoa! Whoa!
Here, Daisy! Here, girl! Hang on, George. I'm almost gone. She's a slippery little sausage.
That should be the newest ride at the amusement park. Daisy's crazy doggy ride.
Okay, you two, let's save that loot for the party.
Okay, Daddy.
I don't suppose I can convince you to go with the windswept look, huh, George?
The surprise party had gone from right on schedule to all over the yard, faster than you could say see spot run. Who would believe one cute little puppy could cause so much trouble?
Hey, George.
Uh-oh.
Did you hear that?
Get Daisy inside, quick!
Did you guys hear a dog?
A dog?
Oh, no, no, no dog here.
That's weird. I thought I heard barking.
Oh, that! That was just a junior playing woof, woof.
Woof, 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 woof.
Oh, too bad. Wouldn't it be fun to have a dog in the neighborhood?
Sure would.
Becky, time to go.
Coming. See you later, George.
Now that was a close one. I had to admit, I was impressed. Junior was cooler than an ice cream sundae. I guess I wasn't giving the little guy enough credit. Thanks, Junior. You really saved the day. Junior, Daisy, and I actually made a pretty great team. With Junior's help, we managed to finish the party preparations and have fun at the same time. I guess four hands are always better than two, especially when there's four wet paws involved.
She's all yours, as long as you take care of her.
Thanks, Mom. This is the best birthday ever.
I'm not sure, but I think Junior officially speaks puppy now.
I can't believe you guys kept the party and the puppy a secret.
You sure did a great job, George. It's not easy pulling the wool over Becky's eyes.
It was a cinch. We had a great time together.
Well, she won't be far away. And you can dog sit, Dick.
Big jumbo, yeah, Zax. Jumbo size. And a snap, snapping for your eyes with a twist. Look at this. Puppets talk and play with you. You can spin them, you can bend them. Just say nothing Zax won't do. Zax sold separately, new from Irwin.
Now, you're the driver on the wildest drive of your life with Tyco's Video Driver. Puts you behind the wheel. Speeding down the highway. Video Driver. Complete with videotape adventure. Other tape adventures sold separately.
Meet PJ Sparkles, shine a love on me, shine, shine, shine.
Meet PJ Sparkles, the doll who loves you back.
When I give you a hug, you light up with love. From morning to night, when I'm holding you tight.
PJ Sparkles, shine a love on me, shine,
I love
shine,
you too.
PJ Sparkles doll, her dress becomes a night. Batteries not included, only from Mattel.
It's Bug Out from Ohio Arts, a fun new game. Alert to the bug! Yep, this is the game. Mr. Bob the Bug into the opponent's net.
Yeah!
Unless you're the bug. Then the object of the game is to bug you. Bug Out, a fun new action game from Ohio Arts, where the name of the game is fun. Unless you're the bug.
Denver, this morning at 11.
Lasers.
Proton cannons, buzzsaw, omni-laser.
Broadside rockets.
Tri-laser.
Questar.
Kulos by Tormeko.
The evil Rulons are tired of playing games.
You are finished, Questar.
They want the Dino Riders' time key.
Your brother eats flies, Kulos.
The greatest battle in the history of the universe is about to begin. Tyrannosaurus Rex and Diplodocus with motorized walking action. And Monoclonius, each with figures and battle gear.
Each sold separately, batteries not included.
Skeletor is waging war for all the power in the universe.
Now it's your turn.
Give it up, Skeletor. I've got He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe.
Come on, He-Man. Come on. Come on. Come on.
You got it, He-Man. You're a hero.
With He-Man.
Figures and accessories each sold separately. New from Mattel.
I'm the Micro Machine Man, and this is the Seriously Small Micro Machine Service City, the perfect place to take your micros for serious servicing. This place has it all. Movable garage doors, liftable lifts, simply amazing service bay, two-level parking, and a totally terrific turning turntable, and the super showroom. The service here is simply stupendous. Micro Machine Service City from Galoom. The Micro Machine Man here, and I'm coming clean about the all-new Micro Machine Car Wash City. It's the best way to clean your micro machine. Drive into the vacuum area, then move your micros through the real rotating rollers. Now this car's really clean, team. Take your perfectly polished micros up the little elevator to the tippy top where you'll find a rotating snack shop.
Micro Machines Car Wash City, Service City sets and vehicles sold separately. Some assembly required from Galoob.
Remember, if it doesn't say Micro Machine, not the real thing.
He's off the camp, his name is Jack. You just can't keep him in the sack. 'Cause Lego makes him cry.